Okay, I want to clear something up here. This whole Venus-Saturn thing, is getting completely out of hand. Venus is the goddess of love, okay? Every song that you hear about Venus, it's all about love, romance, you know, it has to do with sex. The word romance or romantic, okay? Girls say, "Oh, it's so romantic," or "the romantics," or whatever you want. You know, it still has a bad side to it, but it's based on sex. The word romantic is romantics, which means debauchery, which means sex, but it doesn't mean destruction, okay? All your songs about Venus are about a female and about love, okay? It's best known as the goddess of love, okay? Yeah, jealousy and all of that goes with love, but it's not the destroyer. All the songs about Saturn are bizarre, dark, twisted. A lot of them are German, nothing against the German people, but lots of them are Nazi-istic, and they're all about hate, death, and destruction, racism, Arianism, all kinds of bad, really bad stuff. And so this thing that they're trying to say that Venus is the distort, it is not Venus. That is a New Age ploy to cover up the old world order, which is exactly what is staying in place. There is no new world order. It's the old world order being repackaged under this Venus assumption. Purple represents the abyss. It has nothing to do with love. It has to do with a recreation of an older creation that they want to bring into fruition now. In the zodiac, it's the water bearer, Aquarius. Okay, that's Saturn. The return to the golden age of Saturn. Not the return to the golden age of Jupiter or the golden age of Venus. There never was any. Okay? Saturn got to be the big dog because when they looked at the planets, it was number one, it was the one that shone the most light on the nighttime upon the Earth. Number two, it takes the longest to go around the solar system, 29.5 years or 30 years. That's a big number, three, right? And so that all has to do with world domination. Venus has to do with love. So if you want to bullshit people, you use the Venus stuff to tell everybody, "Oh, it's all love and peace and joy." But if you know what you're looking for, the symbols for Saturn are always there. They are not there for Venus. So you guys can keep making these videos because I see this is your new tactic. It's all about Venus. If you go look at Trample on Snake's video with the girl with the red hair, you know what the people with the red hair are? They're the Trojan warriors for Kronos. Got news for you. Kronos ain't Venus. Kronos is Saturn. See? See how that all works out? How interesting. The word Israel from the Phoenicians, what the Jews speak. They're called the children of Israel. Well, who was Israel? The word translates literally into Saturn. So they're the children of Saturn. Hence, the people that are in the know deem the Jews the children of Satan because Satan is synonymous with Saturn. See why? Because it's death and destruction. And everything that surrounds the Jews, they get accused of death and destruction. So you guys can keep playing this Venus card for all you want. 33. It's 9. It's Saturn. On the Kabbalistic tree, 9 is Saturn. Not 8, like some people keep trying to push, because that's on another scale. Okay? All of these murders and stuff, you know, the Columbine thing, what were the kids called? That Klebold and that other kid, what were they called? The Black Trench Coat Mafia, not the Purple Trench Coat Mafia. Okay? People wear Saturn because it's its color of authority, Saturn. It's black, it's Romanesque. It goes back to the original laws of Phoenicia. And Phoenicia didn't have jack shit to do with Venus. That's all more tied up with poetry and love and reasons for birth and sex and all of that. A matter of fact, Jesus is more associated with Venus than he ever was with Saturn. Look at the seal of Saturn, which is basically called a crosshatch design, represents the cubes that the entities are locked in. Period. Hitler's game is he wanted to get the middle of the Earth, like you saw in the movie Prometheus. Well, that was based on what Hitler was doing. He wanted to get down there to release those things. Then he would be in command of them, and there would be a race of supermen. Go look at the symbol on Superman's chest. It's got an S in it. It's a sine wave. It represents time. It represents the planet Saturn. So here we have a race of big 6'6" guys that are supermen wearing red and blue. Gee whiz, what are those colors associated with? The purple represents the abyss. Okay? When you go watch the show I Dream a Genie, what did she wear? She always wore purple. Why? Because a genie in Arabic is a jinn, and a jinn is a demonic entity. Okay? All of these planets and all of this stuff all have an evil side to them in one aspect or another. But that one, the one with the ring around it, which is incidentally why you wear a ring around your finger, because it's the god of matrimony, not Venus. Okay? He's the god of agriculture. He's the god of everything on this planet. Why? Because Satan is the ruler of this world. That's why. That's what we're really talking about here. Saturn is just the name of the planet, but because it's the biggest and the baddest, he's the dude that's running everything down here, but he's androgynous. He's split into two factions, the male and the female. Okay? But it's the female aspect of this whole thing that is the destroyer. So what they're doing is they're trying to take the fact that it's a female and Venus is a female, and they're trying to put those together to say that it's Venus. It's not Venus. It's the female aspect of Saturn. When you look at a Pepsi can, you got a red, you got a blue, and you got a white line. One is the positive, one is the negative. And the white line in between is the perfect balance. So male, female. The female is the negative, not the positive. The male is the positive. The white line in between is the perfect harmonic balance between the two. So you've got science, you've got alchemy, you've got theology, you've got mythology. But, you know, please, you know, the cops don't wear a six-pointed star in purple suits. Okay? They're wearing black because black is the color of Saturn. It's the god of authority. And, you know, and the Masons, you know, they may have a thing going with this whole Venus thing, but it's not their main gig. That's why their floors are checkered black and white. That all goes back to Phoenicia, which Phoenicia didn't have shit to do with. The Phoenicians had nothing to do with Venus. And no, it's not Phoenician blinds, it's Venetian blinds. They go on a window, you dope. All right, so there you go. Now, the other aspect is that one of the most outer rings of Saturn is completely purple. Do you think maybe that might have something to do with it? Maybe the people that run this planet, maybe they gauge what's going on here or what they're trying to do by the different colors and the rings of Saturn. Maybe, just like a CD as the information feeds out from the center, unlike a record or an LP that went from the outside in, maybe the purple that we're seeing is the ring of Saturn that shows that this is the end of the cycle and a new cycle is about to begin. I don't know. I'm just saying, just go look. One of the outer rings, there's a couple very differing degrees of purple within those rings, but there's seven major rings, which is where you get your notes, which is the one of the outer rings, I think it might be the G or the F ring, is purple. Who's to say? Maybe that's the way this whole thing works. Maybe the people on Earth that run this and know the old Babylonian laws look up at Saturn, and when they see a certain ring has come into fruition, maybe that's how they set things in motion. I don't know. I'm not privy to it. I don't belong to any organizations. I don't read the Kabbalah. You know? I don't have the book in my house, although a lot of people have accused me of having it, seem to be showing it off themselves and, you know, taking, you know, romantic shots with their boyfriend and girlfriend, but we're not going there because that's a done deal with me. That's over with. So just think about it. It's the seal of Saturn. It's not the seal of Venus. Show me what the seal of Venus is. I'd love to see it. Somebody came on last night and said, Barbarian Rebellion made a video last night. You should check it out. Maybe you'll learn something. Nah, I'm afraid not. That ain't going to happen anytime soon. I think he's the one that said a couple weeks ago that it was the return of the Golden Age of Jupiter. Go figure. One last thing. If Venus is the goddess of love and Saturn is the god of chaos and destruction, where do you think we sit in the world right now? Which one do you think is a stronger force? Look at the banking situation. Look at the wars that are going on. Which one do you really think is running the show here? Is it really Venus? Really, guys? You know, I'm not supporting this whole Saturnalia thing. I'm trying to show you that's what it is. I wish the fuck none of this was happening. Oh, hello, Venusians. I guess that's what I call you. Those that think that Venus is behind all of this. Well, let's take a look at this. This is a recent picture of Saturn taken by Cassini. Okay? That's a satellite that we sent out to go look at Saturn. Interesting, all of the purple, isn't that nice? Purple and green. Gee whiz, where do we see that? We see it all the time when we're talking about ghosts and ghouls and all kinds of neat stuff like that. But what's really important is let's take a look at the data that Cassini sent back. Okay, so let's take a look at what it says. It says, unraveling Saturn's rings, blah, blah, blah. The colors used to is used to present information about the ring's particles in different regions based on measurements and in three radio signals. Three simultaneous radio signals of 0.94, 3.6, and 13 centimeter waves or wavelengths, Ka, X, and S band, were sent from the Cassini spacecraft through the rings to Earth. The observed change of each signal as Cassini moved behind the rings and provided a profile distributed the rings and blah, blah, blah. Now, let's see what's really being said here, shall we? Remember, I'm keeping my mind open and seeing if I can find anything in here that has anything to do with Venus. Okay, so the first one they talk about is the Ka band. Let's see what the Ka band, or Ka, which is incidentally the sound that a crow makes, or a blackbird, what? Do you remember? The Venetians, do you remember? Yeah, the crow is the messenger to Saturn, remember? Not the Venus, though. Just thought I'd bring that up. Venus would probably be more like a hummingbird, okay? Because it's real, supposed to be real nice. Saturn, not so much. So let's see what Ka or Ka really is. And let's see. The Ka or the Ba and the Kabbalah, the science of the afterlife. Hey, Venetians, this is going out to you, Barbarian Rebellion. Take a look, buddy. It's got purple in it. Uh-oh, we know that the Kaaba, that big black square, what does that represent? Come on. It's all right, Aaron. It's all right. You can give me a grin. All right, see, that hurt a bit. Yeah, see, this refers back to Saturn, see? We got the black, we got the purple, the yellow, we got the Yahoo, and then we got Yahweh. I'm not seeing any Venetian stuff in here. All right, hang on. We gotta make sure, though. I gotta make sure that all these years of studying, I didn't mess it all up on something stupid. Hang on. Okay, let's take a look. What do we got here? We got Adele, this big, fat British broad, singing Rolling in the Deep. How about that? What's in the deep? The abyss. But look at what's on here, a big X. So we've got the Ka, and we've got the X. Oh, and let's see, Rolling in the Deep. And what is the deep? Yeah, it's that nasty place where those water creatures, like the Little Mermaid, called Ariel, which is a Kabbalistic spirit of the abyss. Yeah, you know the one. Yeah, not of Venus, but of Saturn. The abyss, all the evil, really scary stuff. Because we know that Venus is love and sex and all that wonderful stuff that people like to do. But that the bad part of all of this stuff is the Saturn thing. But let's just make sure here. Let me slide this other picture of her in there so we can make sure that it's really the purple is referring to the abyss. And of the whole Saturn alien or Saturnine overlord, shall I put it. Okay, and the next bandwidth is the S. Gee whiz. Now that's the easy one. Most readily recognized as the serpent, Leviathan, if you will. It represents a sine wave. A sine wave abbreviation is sin in physics. Okay, it represents time. And let's see, let me check my records here. Who was the god of time and space? And he didn't create it, by the way. Although there's somebody out there who keeps saying I said that. I never said that. I said it represents time and space. And if, to the truth be known, if you want to put any validity in the fact that the planet Saturn, not Venus, represents Satan. Because if you spell it with a V, it'd be Vaten. Hey, sounds like somebody from Hungary. I've been waiting for this chain all day. What is your name? Melvin Eugene Punymire. And the geeks shall inherit the earth. Anyway, the S represents time. The X is the oldest written symbol for the planet Saturn. And the Ka is for the Kabbalah. And this ain't got jack shit to do with science. It has everything to do with alchemy and witchcraft. And I know that you guys fucking hate me. And I know that you've been trying to get me off of YouTube forever and ever and ever and ever. And I know that you're going, oh, it's that pesky Jew. Especially that guy, Harp Won't Be Silent. That guy hates me like there's no tomorrow. Ugh, it's that pesky Jew. What will we do? What shall we do with this uppity Jew? Yeah, I know it. I get it. Ain't no love lost here, buddy. You go ahead, you can keep flipping around. 1 week it's Saturn, or I mean 1 week it's Venus, the next it's Mercury, what's gonna be next week? Pluto? Well, if you wanna see Pluto, you'll have to watch Disney, because that's where he's at. Okay? You know why they got rid of Pluto? Because he was fucking goofy. Alright. Okay, here's the little fellow that took the pictures of Saturn, and look what it's called. It's called Cassini. But what's interesting about this is it's spelled C-A-S-S-I-N-I. Okay? Let's just keep that in mind. C-A-S-S-I-N-I. Now, why do you think they called it that? Gee whiz, would this have something to do with Venus? I'm not sure. Let me check it out. So we see here that the word Cassiel, how interesting, Cassiel. And Cassini, it's just a couple letters different, but they both have the root word, Cassie. So here we have Cassie L. And all of these have an L. Capriel, Chamuel, Sayudel, Abdiel, Anaphiel. Who is? There's a lot of L's happening here. I don't see anything going on with you. Honor this deception, fat destroyer, Satan, A-L. Okay, Satan is who? That's Saturn, it's not Venus. Although I heard Venus has got a nice ass. Don't know what to tell you. Oh, and before this is over, I just wanted to hit you to one other little thing. Because I know how much you guys hate me, so I want to make a gesture, a token, to give you a little bit of information that you don't know. Okay, let's take a look here. Just something else to hit this video. In pre-Islamic days, the god Hubble was Saturn. Didn't they make a telescope called the Hubble telescope? And that the holy stone of the Kaaba served the same symbolic function. It's Saturn, not Venus. Oh, by the way, Ka and Abba means father. So here we have Father Satan. Ka. Oh, God. I know what you're thinking. Ugh, this pesky Jew. What should we do with this pesky Jew? I know, we'll take him, we'll wash him, and make him all clean, and put him on Sam Zittle's crucifixion machine. I didn't come in a car, I didn't come in a Jeep, I didn't come riding in the pocket of a high-jumping bo-peep. Okay, I get it. I know you guys don't like me, and I ain't got nothing against you, but you guys got this vendetta against me for whatever reason. I don't know if you're a spiritual entity. I don't know if you're a program. I don't even know what the fuck my own existence is. But don't sit here and try and bullshit me about what's running this planet, because Saturn is Satan. It's just all code. It's code. And I'm sorry that people didn't ever sit down and read the Bible and they can't understand that the Bible has many facets to it and that there's all kinds of shit going on here. That the Bible says that there's more going on in heaven that have ever been dreamt in the minds of men. So, whatever. You guys want to keep waging war with me, that's fine. I really don't have anything against you. But, you know, come on, quit bullshitting people. I spent years and years and years. It's based on the planet Saturn because he's the big dog, he's the god of authority in this realm. Alright? I say peace, but that doesn't really mean anything. Although, speaking of peace, I told you, I heard Venus has got a nice ass. So, whatever, that's it. I'm out. Oh, I know what you're saying. Let's just hate that Jew. I know. I'm so neat I can hardly stand myself.